Research from the EEF suggests that professional development, or PD, is more effective when it includes key mechanisms. Drawn from research on human behaviour, these mechanisms have been shown to lead to changes in practice. There are 14 mechanisms in total. These can be split into four groups according to their purpose. These are building knowledge, motivating teachers, developing teacher techniques, and embedding practice. PD, which includes at least one mechanism from each of these four groups, is more likely to lead to a lasting change to practice. The first group of mechanisms ensures that PD builds knowledge by presenting new information in ways that support understanding. Teachers' cognitive load should be carefully managed when presenting new information, for example, by focusing only on the most relevant content or through using multiple examples. PD should also build in opportunities to revisit prior learning, using tasks and other strategies such as quizzing to encourage the recall of information from past sessions to make it more likely that this is retained over time. Once teachers have built knowledge, they need to be motivated to act upon it. There are three mechanisms which can be used to support this. Research has shown that setting specific goals increases the likelihood that teachers will fulfill these goals and that performance will improve. Teachers can also be motivated to change practice by presenting information from a credible source. This can be achieved by supporting suggestions with robust research or by featuring a prominent academic or an expert teacher to promote a particular practice. Once teachers have shown progress towards making changes to practice, acknowledging their efforts and reinforcing key messages may improve teachers' motivation to act upon PD. To effectively develop teacher techniques, PD should provide teachers with the tools they need to take action. There are five mechanisms in this group, and together, these highlight the importance of providing clear instruction on how to perform particular techniques, underpinned by evidence from trusted sources. Arranging social support to enable teachers to discuss any problems and provide peer support and assistance. Modelling techniques using videos or demonstrations from expert practitioners to allow teachers to observe problems and consider potential solutions before facing these themselves in practice. Providing supportive, formative feedback to help teachers improve specific techniques. And providing opportunities to rehearse techniques at least once before implementing them in classroom contexts. Once teachers have developed understanding of key techniques, PD programs then need to support teachers to embed changes into practice. There are four mechanisms in this group. Providing prompts and cues, such as by giving reminders in staff meetings or via emails, can help to remind teachers to continue to use key techniques. Action planning also makes it more likely that teachers will use techniques they have learned. Action plans should consider how and when techniques will be used, as well as how often these will be repeated. Teachers should also be encouraged to monitor their own performance, such as by using reflective journals to record their actions towards a specific goal and reflect on the success of them. Finally, research suggests that repeating the same action in the classroom at least twice can support teachers to embed new techniques into practice. Research found that the more mechanisms a PD program has, the more likely it is to lead to a sustained change in teacher behaviour and to positively impact pupil attainment. Research also emphasises the importance of including at least one mechanism from each of the four groups. Where one of these groups is missing, PD is less likely to be successful. For example, if a PD programme includes mechanisms to build knowledge, motivate teachers, and develop teacher techniques, but does not embed practice, it is likely that change will not be sustained and that teachers will revert to previous practices. This means that when designing or selecting PD programs, it is important to carefully consider the mechanisms these use, remembering it is not just the number of mechanisms which is important, but also whether there is at least one mechanism from each of the four different groups. To support teachers and school leaders to use this evidence, the EEF have developed a range of resources to support PD design, including planning templates, as well as the full guidance report. These can be downloaded by visiting our website at eef.li/epd.